one time this guy got killed around my neighborhood, and he looked a lot like me. And my mother called me the next morning, like when she seen his face in the newspaper. She hadn't heard from me in like a week or so. I was out there, and she was scared. She was like, I just wanted to make sure you was all right. You could hear like a cry in her voice, you know what I'm saying, because she thought I was gone. It's like this conversation that you have with your mom and tell her like, yo, you're going to be all right. And she don't know that you're going to be all right, you know what I'm saying? And neither do you. It's like you lied to her, you know what I'm saying? And she accepts the lie because the lie like kind of helps her sleep a little bit at night. So like, I'll just call you in the morning, you know what I'm saying? But she never knows that you're like, okay, until then.
Mama, they try to kill your baby. What do you want us to do? Mama, you said Jesus gon' save me. But what if when he come back, he only takes you?
It's really crazy out here for people, especially like in our neighborhoods and just with this color skin. Just, I mean, you see the news, you see it. So I think we all have that conversation. We'll be all right. So I'll call you in. This one of your sons died, now you're mourning, so I understand why you're worried about me. So it's not just like my mom, it's like everybody's mom.
Mama, another one of your sons died, now you're mourning. Watch your son rise in the morning. And I know. Mama, another one of your sons died, now you're mourning. I know.